I know your type. You're a surgical junkie.
Yes, sir.
It's not going to be easy for you to be away from the OR that long.
No, sir.
And if you want to get back to the OR, you're going to tell me what I want to know, aren't you?
You're right. It's not easy for me to be away from the OR. It's not easy for me to sit in front of you, or any authority figure for that matter, and not be able to give you the exact answer you want to hear. I'm the one with the answers. I've always been the one with the answers, but right now, sir, I don't have any.
Dr. Yang?
How do you keep your edge, sir? I watch you. You've been doing this a long time. You're focused, you are the job, nothing gets to you, and the thing is, sir, I was like that. Until I got here. Until I started actually doing this job and everything is fuzzy.
That's beside the point.
No. See, sir, this is the point because I can't tell you. What happened in that room, I can't tell you. And before, I could have. No guilt, no loyalties, no problem. Before, I wouldn't even have been in that room. I wouldn't even have gotten involved. I would have never froze in surgery. I would have told him what I thought he should do. I had an edge, sir. I had an edge, and I've lost it, and I need it back. I need it back now. So if you could just tell me how you keep yours and how to not be affected, I know I could be a great surgeon. So if you could just give me the answers, I would really appreciate it.
You're excused, Dr. Yang.
But
you're excused.
I'll tell you who cut the LVAD wires, sir, if you could just...
No, you won't. I don't want to know. Not from you. Yeah, I have the answers, but I can't tell them to you. I'm not going to be responsible for you becoming less human.